Welcome, welcome. It is Latrice Bartley with Purposefully Living. Y'all, it's Fit Friday. It is Fit Friday. Are you hyped? It's Fit Friday. It is time to get focused, intentional, and tenacious about Christ first and our goals second. Christ first and our goals second. Listen, I'm so excited. I want to just jump right in because I feel like I have so much to say. And so I want to just encourage you, but I got to do first things first, and I need to give a disclaimer, y'all. Okay, my body going through some changes. I don't know what's going on. I don't have COVID, y'all, okay? So don't get scared. I don't have COVID, but I'm just telling you, my sinus is draining. I'm sweating. I don't know. I go through this every now and then. Look, it's all a part of that Olivia experience. I'm serious. So if you see me, you know, dabbing my head, my nose, I'm all right. But everything, I feel like draining at one time. But let's get in. It's Fit Friday. So maybe you're watching me and you're like, what is Fit Friday? I know you had Motivational Monday, but what is Fit Friday? Well, Motivational Monday reminds us that every day it is important. It is our opportunity to jumpstart our day in the Word of God. Bottom line, it is my way to encourage you to get in the Word of God, because God's Word is our manual for life. It is our spiritual navigation system. Fit Friday, God gave me to just still keep encouraging you, to encourage you to stay fit, to get fit, to tighten up. And when you think about it, naturally speaking, fit to be fit, you know, that's what we all striving for, right? We want to be healthy. We want to have a fit lifestyle. But the reality is you have to stay the course. Every day is an opportunity to throw in a towel. So it's just another way for me to encourage you to get focused, intentional, and tenacious about Christ so that you can purposely live. I say this all the time. Sometimes if we're looking on the natural side, we have stayed the course. Listen, we've been eating our protein and our veggies and minimizing the sugar. And then Friday come, and even though it's our cheat day, but we just want to throw it all in. You know, we're going to get the pizza, the crabs, that we're going to do it all. And it's like, no. We got to get fit. We got to stay fit. You know, and so it's in just, we can splurge a little, but it's learning how to make our health journey a lifestyle. Same thing. Maybe you're getting fit in your finances. How can you make it a lifestyle? Maybe you used to just going out and splurging. You just spend $2,500 at one time. Okay, if you got it like that, great. But some of us really don't. And even if that is it might not be a good habit, but how can you get fit in your finances? How can you get fit in your marriage? How can you get fit in your parenting? And so, listen, this get fit is a whole lifestyle, y'all. It is reminding us that everything, we want to give it to God. And so being fit, I can't stress it enough, is more spiritual than it is physical, because God begins to work from the inside out. It's a transformation process. It's giving your life, all that your life encompasses, to God and allowing Him daily to lead you and guide you so that you can be fit. So if you want to be fit in your health, give it to God. You want to be fit in your parenting? Give it to God. You want to be fit in your marriage? Give it to God. You want to be fit in your business? Give it to God. When you start with God, oh my God, then that's when you will begin to see a transformation in anything you put in His hands. So my job is always just to encourage you. That's what I'm here for. I'm here to encourage you in the Word and to walk out whatever your goals are. So I want to talk to you today. Fit Friday today is about following Jesus. I want you to get fit. But I'm going to tell you how to get fit. And it begins in following Jesus. Now, this shouldn't be, you know, nothing too mind-blowing if you've been following me. Because I give this disclaimer. I can't give you tools and resources that don't include Jesus. I'm probably not going to be your girl if you just want something inspirational or motivational outside. No, I want to get you fit so that when life happens, and when maybe you're discouraged, or maybe you really are, you've been going strong and you hit that plateau, or you hit that obstacle, you can persevere through, you can push through. So I'm going to jump right in because it's a lot, y'all, and I want to kind of stay to my time. So, all right, today we are going to talk about, I'm encouraging you to get fit by following Jesus. Now, what do I mean by this? And here's the thing that I want to just kind of set the tone, okay? When we are getting fit, as I stress so often, and I say a lot of times, I like to speak through fitness because it's a passion of mine. I'm a fitness fanatic. I love running. I love weights. I love everything about the gym. I just love fitness. So God, a lot of times, speaks to me through what makes sense. You know, he'll use things that are just that we can understand. And so a lot of times he speaks through my fitness journey. But getting fit is not about having this body. It is about total health in your mind, spirit, and your body, okay? So when I'm talking about following Jesus, what do I mean? And I want to kind of put it in a natural analogy. You know, when you think about following somebody, and I will use my children, I have literally all week been drilling into them obedience, obedience, obedience. Because my kids, you know, they'll look at me and so if I say something, let's say really strong, like, y'all don't like me. I do that sometimes, get dramatic on them. Y'all don't like your mama. You don't believe your mama. You don't care. You know, and they be looking like, yes, I do. And I go strong like that because I tell them, I said, listen, it's not about you saying, Mom, I love you. Mom, I do care about you. I know that you do when you obey and do what I've asked you. If it's something simple as you clean off the table when you finish, I don't want you to just listen to me. I don't want you to just believe me, but I want you to follow. Do what I say. Like, that's how I know you really listening. That's how I know that you believe. I want to see the demonstration. Well, that's how God is. He don't want us to just listen to him. He don't want us to just believe him, but he wants us to follow him. There's three steps to this whole process. Yes, we have to listen through the word, but y'all, that's step one. You have so many that we're listening, but do we really believe? Then you have some that they like, I believe, but God, I can't follow. Then do you believe? So they all work together, okay? And so I really want to deal with following Jesus. And trust me, just hang with me. I promise you it's going to all make sense. Just, I'm going to bring it home. Follow means to move or travel behind, to treat as a teacher or a guide, to obey, to pursue a way of life. When you follow, and it's like, I'm pursuing a way of life, to imitate. But here's where I really want to stay. To adhere to something, and to practice something. So you're not only are you going, when you're following somebody, if somebody say, come on and follow me, you don't just stand there, right? Come on and follow me. You just stand there. They be like, do you hear me? Because listening is not it's not just I heard you, but to follow them, you got to move. They expecting you to imitate what they're doing, or to get to moving your feet. Follow me. They be looking at you like, did you hear what I said? Why are you just standing there? You say, I listen. I believe you. No, follow me. Come with me. Well, y'all, that's what it means. When we're following Jesus, there's an action that's required. There's a movement that's required, okay? So let's jump right in. Why is this important? I want to encourage you that sometimes when we are, I think about, again, another practical example, when we are teaching our children, we teach our children, do not follow a stranger. Listen, if you don't know them, you don't follow them. If they say, hey, come here, you can do this. If you don't know them, don't follow what they say. We teach them that, right? But let's say professionally, I might look at someone or find someone on the internet, and because they're a subject matter expert, I don't necessarily know them, but something about them that, you know, whether it's an expertise, I say, I'll follow them. I'll get the information and I'll begin to do it because they have laid a foundation in that area that I'm like, okay, I believe it. But my point is the same way we teach our children and even ourselves. I mean, if you said, hey, Latrice, why don't you, you know, I see you in the store. Come here. I don't know you. I'm not going where you're going. Why am I saying that? You can't follow someone you don't know. You cannot move. You cannot obey. You cannot follow someone you don't know. And so when I'm talking about getting fit in your finances, getting fit in your health, getting fit in your marriage, getting fit in your parenting, it's saying getting focused, intentional, and tenacious about Christ first and your goals second. But how do you get fit and follow someone you don't know? So I want to take back and encourage you, get to know your Savior. You have to get to know Jesus. You have to know who he is. And you do that by getting in your word, y'all. I can't stress that enough. It is as you dive into the word of God that you learn who he is. Because the bottom line is, as you get in that word, guess what happens? You develop a relationship. To get fit, you got to have a relationship with him. You have to be able to give him, trust him with your finances, trust him with your life, trust him with your marriage. And that begins as you have a relationship. But I want to deal with that word, okay? Really quick, y'all know I'm a teacher at heart, so just bear with me. A relationship is such an important term. And when I was prepping for this, I thought about how some of us really have a problem following Jesus because we don't understand that this process is really foundational because it's about a relationship. It's not religion. It's not based on philosophy. It's not because your mama knew Jesus. You know Jesus. You can't ride in on your mama's salvation. You can't ride in on your spiritual father's salvation. No, this is an individual walk. Just because you know me, you ain't going to get into that. Like, you got to make a decision. So when we're getting fit and we're going to follow, we have to know who we're following. But you can't really know him if you haven't developed a relationship. But here's what I thought about. Some of us, the reason we can't follow and we don't have a great relationship, because we don't even understand what a relationship is. If you think about it, some of our relationships experience is a hot mess. Some of us think a relationship is just a sexual experience. It's a love affair. That's unhealthy. Like, we don't even realize that the relationship we in ain't even a relationship. It's just a sexual experience. All you do is use each other for sex. But, and then y'all can't even really dwell with each other. Y'all don't even really like each other. But you, hey, when we in the bed, we good. That's an unhealthy relationship. Look, some of us, our relationships is really opportunities. We meet people and get with people because what can we get from them? We're going to use them. Oh, they know so many people. If I get to know them, I could get to this person. Some of us are just plain old, listen, we just deceitful. We just always got something up our sleeve. That's an unhealthy relationship. Okay, so for some of us, our relationships are emotional connections. We just love to love you. You know, I love to feel it. I want to be with you. Oh, you inspire me. We just got this emotional connection. So why am I saying all of that? Because if you don't have the right foundation of an understanding of what a healthy relationship is, we will treat our relationship with Christ the same way. Some of us, we just about a spiritual booty call. It's like, what can you do for me? I call you, I need something today. I need something today. We always just need something. Just, you know, just come service me. That's what we do. Like the sexual experience. Some of us, we just love Jesus. Oh, I love Jesus. If somebody asks you, I mean, who would say I don't love Jesus? I mean, there are some. But I'm just saying, we love the idea of loving the Lord, but we don't love him enough to obey him and do what he says. And then for some of us, it's an opportunity. Like, yeah, I'm gonna serve God. What he gonna do for me? If I serve God, is this miracle gonna happen? If I serve God, can I hit six figures? It's all about what can I get from him. So when we think back, we need to even be able to get fit and follow, we got to go back to the relationship. Maybe you need a whole new understanding of what a relationship is to really be about. Because a relationship is a two-way exchange. It is giving and taking. It's submitting and yielding. I think about even my marriage relationship. There's times that Javier, he's pouring into me. There's times that I'm pouring into him. There's an exchange. There's a submission one to another. You know, and so it's never a case, and it's not a 50-50. It's we all in. There's 100. And do you always get back? Not always, but he probably always don't get back. You know, and so it's constantly saying how it's listening. I can't just, no, you listen to me. But he can't ever tell me anything. Well, that's a problem. And so y'all, nor do he, as my husband, even being my husband, want to be treated like, what can I get from you? What are you going to do for me? Come get in the bed with me. Like, he like, okay, hold on. You know, so my point is, we have to, number one, really begin to say, Lord, help me. I haven't established great relationships. I'm not even a good friend. You know, if I go back and think about it, so Lord, make me a good friend. Show me and give me healthy relationships so that I can even understand how the value of who you are to me and what it's like to be in a relationship with my Heavenly Father, with my Savior. Okay, so let's keep going. Now, in Matthew 16 and 24 through the 26th verse, I want you to read in the Message version. We see this word a lot, and it's disciple. And what a disciple means is a follower. It is to be a follower of Christ. And again, y'all, that's what I want to do. I want to encourage you of what it means to follow Jesus, because you can't get fit, which is a whole lifestyle, if you're not going to follow. If you think about it naturally, think about your health journey. If I'm going to get fit in my body, there's something I can't just, I'm going to get fit. Well, how? You have to either get you a trainer. You're going to pull up some stuff on the internet. There's something you have to adhere to and put into practice. You can't just say, I'm going to get a body, and you're not going to do anything. Well, are you going to follow the meal tips? Are you going to follow what the trainer do? There's an action that's required, okay? So listen, going back to Matthew 16, 24 through 26 in the Message version, it talks about this word disciple, which means to be a follower. And that's what God is after, us being followers of Christ. Now, Jesus had a message to deliver, and just bear with me. Listen, I'm gonna be honest, either log on or stay or go off. But I can't ever encourage you without first putting a foundation of the spiritual foundation. Because like I said, getting fit is total health in your body, mind, and spirit. But you won't realize that it starts with God first, and then it just flows to every other area. So bear with me. So in here, Jesus had a message to deliver in the scripture, and it was about God's kingdom, his Heavenly Father. The message was, the kingdom of God is near, right? Within reach. And he was given an open invitation to listen. It's within your reach. But he said, in order to inherit the kingdom of God, you had to do something. You had to repent and turn from your sins, believe and follow. So what does repent mean, y'all? Let me I'm a teacher. Repent means to change your mind and change directions. It's a dual thing. You can in your mind regret something and change your mind, but it's another thing to change your action. In other words, recognize you're wrong and turn away. Follow, listen, go a whole nother direction. That's what we have to do in order to inherit the kingdom of God. This is what his message was. His message was, listen, you got to turn, repent, believe, and follow. And I'm saying that because, again, we're okay with listening. We're okay with listening to the pastor. We're okay with listening to the podcast, feeling that emotional connection. All right. Yes, I love Jesus, right? We'll believe what they say. I believe, you know, I believe there's a hell, there's a heaven. I believe that God loves me. But then it's something about that follow thing. When it comes time to now putting it into action, it's like, we stop. But that's what's required for you to get what you need. Because in order for you to get fit, it's a dual relationship. There's a part you have to play. It's not for Jesus to just do stuff. You got a part to play. It's a relationship. And so you have to obey. You have to submit. You have to follow. You have to be willing to eat right. You have to be willing to go to the gym. It's a whole process that you are a participator on. You can't just listen. You can't just believe. But God wants us to follow. So here's the thing. He had a message, right? And here's to reach the kingdom. He was letting them know, you have to follow. Now I'm going to give you some examples, and I want you to read this later. Mark 1, 14 through 16 talks about this process. And it says, and Simon and Andrew were casting their nets. They were fishermen, okay? And here's what happened. Jesus came up to them and he said, follow me. That's all he said. He said, come, follow me. He said, and I will make you fishermen of people. Now, why am I using this? I'm gonna give you another example. Because again, when you are gonna get fit, when you're gonna have a lifestyle of fitness, when you are gonna be focused, intentional, and tenacious about Christ so you can walk out the purpose he has for your life and conquer these goals, you got to follow him. They had to move. He ain't give them no instructions. He ain't tell them no process. He ain't tell them you gonna become sick. You gonna level up and get six figures. He ain't say you about to be your dream house. He ain't tell them you was gonna heal people. He just said, come and follow me. Do that sound like your life? Some things God just tell us and we got to follow. He not giving us anything else until we do that. We want the plan. We want to level up. But he said, you won't even follow me. I'm just telling you to move when I tell you to move. I'm telling you to yield your life to me. But you asking me about seven figures. You asking me about living your best life. I just want to know, will you follow me? So they had to move, not even knowing the plan. It's like, well, who are you? Where are we going? Where you going to take me to? Are we going to spend the night there? See, that's how we do. We want the details, myself included. But God said, I'm not required to give you that. He said, I said, come and follow me. So he told them, and here's what it says. At once, they left their nets and followed. Here's another example. James and John were asked to follow. And they left what they had. And I know if you think about it naturally, it's like, but why would they do that? They don't even know. But something I believe about Jesus, it intrigued them. I believe it was something that it was like, I'm going to go. I'm going to see what this is about. And y'all, it's the same thing. To follow is a faith walk. To follow and trust. But we have to know who we following. You got to get in the word and know who he is. To know how he loves you so much. To know that for him to require you to do something, he's trying to give you everything. You got to know who you following. And when you know who Jesus is, it's easy to move even when you don't understand. So let me keep going. So y'all, but here is what I want you to understand. Ooh, my nose draining. Here's what I want you to understand. To follow Jesus, you will always have to leave something. Always. Always. Why? Because it's a participation. He wants you to participate. You can't serve and follow Jesus and have your own agenda. You can't follow Jesus and do what you want to do. No, when you follow, you adhere to what you... I mean, think about it in school. If you're going to follow and the teacher tell you, get in line, follow, you can't tell the teacher, I'm going this way. This actually a quicker way. You don't know what the teacher trying to teach you. The teacher might be telling you to go this way so that she can show you the fire extinguisher so that if anything happened, you know where to go. But you got your, we could get there quicker. That ain't what the teacher told you to do. Fall back and get in line. My point is, y'all, when we follow, we're going to have to, we might think that we know. But God said, I know the plans that I have for you. I know the best route. I'm going to be the one to watch over you. I'm the one that's going to show you the best pathway for your life. We have to be willing to follow. We can't tell Jesus, well, I know my gift is lending to this and this would give me. Okay, we'll see what your gift gets you. But when God asks you to do something, he's never requiring you to do something that he's not going to give you so much more. But we have to be willing to follow. And so, as I said, whenever we're following Jesus, you can't keep your agenda. It requires you to give up something. Even think about your trainer. If you pay, again, I like to talk in health and fitness. If you pay a trainer, you can't pay a trainer and then you're going to come in there and tell them what you're going to do. Oh no, I can't do that. And actually, if I squat this way, I mean, can't my thighs get thin? It's like, well, who you going to, you going to train yourself or you going to listen to me? You got to follow. You have to be willing to do the hard stuff. It's going to mean giving up some things. You might have to give up those chips and give up all the sugar and give up because you're trying to get somewhere. And the guy in the way, obviously, if you hiring a trainer, you ain't been too successful on your own. So now you need some additional help. But you got to be willing to follow. You got to listen to instructions, do the reps, do the eating, get up and go to the gym. It's the same way. We want these blessings. We want this great lifestyle, but we're not willing to follow Christ. We're not willing to obey his word. So listen, we have to be willing to follow. And why am I saying this is so important, y'all? Because when you get fit, when you get focused, intentional, and tenacious, and begin to follow Christ, if you want to get fit in your body, you're going to have to give up. Remember, I said to follow Christ, you got to give up something. I want you to understand, to get fit, to live a fit lifestyle, it requires you to give up something. If you want a fit body, you have to give up your time and go to the gym. If you want a fit body, sometimes you got to give up sugar and unhealthy habits and replace them with healthy ones. If you want to be fit in your finances, you will have to give up spending everything and save. If you want a fit marriage, you may have to learn how to submit one to another. You might have to keep your mouth shut. You can't always be right. Listen, if you want fit kids, then you might have to be willing to teach. You can't throw them off on somebody else. You might have to cut off the iPad and sit down and spend some time with them so you can see some things is wrong. You can see their strengths and know how to capitalize on that, but also see their weaknesses and know how to pray. In other words, you got to spend some time with your kids. You can't throw them in front of a TV and have a fit parenting, fit kid. No. It requires you to do some work. So anything that you're going to have a fit, you're going to be tight and right, it requires work. It requires you to give up. And when to follow Jesus, you have to be willing to get fit, y'all. So having a fit lifestyle requires sacrifice. It requires time. It requires that you start with Christ. Now, Matthew 16, 24 through 26, y'all, in the Message version, read this. It says, anyone who intends to come with me, this is Jesus, has to let me lead. You're not in the driver's seat. I am. Y'all, I'm telling you, this fit lifestyle is more spiritual than y'all think is natural. This is what the word said. It says, anyone who intends to come with me, I have to lead. You can't lead your own life. And so you might have been listening to me because, again, like I say, these words bother us. Repent. I'm a sinner. I mean, which I do good. I give all my hours. She don't even know how much I give. Do you know how many jobs? That ain't got nothing to do with your fit lifestyle. I said get focused, intentional, and tenacious about Jesus. I ain't talking about what you do. What you doing for him? Where is he the focus? That's the problem. We get feely about what we do. But God said it ain't about you. You here for me. And so if you gonna get fit and you gonna live, it's not gonna be about you. It's what he can do through you. So what I want you to understand, it says, yes, if you might have done a lot of good. You might have given a lot of money. But at the end of the day, that's not what being fit is all about. He lets us know in Matthew 16, 24 through 26, if you're going to come with him, he said, I got to leave. So you might need to repent, and not might. Your repentance, maybe you not drinking. Maybe you ain't in the street smoking. Maybe you haven't been in and out of somebody's bed. Okay, great. But that don't make you no saint. Where have you said, Lord, you are leading my life? Your sin is that you in control. Your sin is nobody can't tell you nothing. No, you so honorary. You a liar. You are deceitful. You listen, all of that. So God said, you won't even love. Somebody could just ask you to do something. I ain't doing that. I mean, just honoring. God said, you need to repent and allow me to lead. You want to be in the driver's seat so bad, and you driving yourself on a one-way highway. You don't even know you headed for destruction. Y'all, you need to know who Jesus is so you can follow him. So as we continue on Matthew 16, 24 through 6, it says self-help is no help at all. Self-sacrifice is the way, my way. That's what he's wanting. You can't self-help yourself. I mean, again, we think that we know more than we do, but it starts with Jesus. It starts in our submission. It starts. I like to say the Lord showed me this the other day because I was talking to him. I said, Lord, this whole leveling up, everybody want to level up. And I just don't, you know, okay, I'm going to leave that alone. But I'm like, where you going? You know, level up to what? We just take these terminologies and what do they really mean? But God was showing me, if they want to know how to level up, level down. You want to know how to go places, get on your knees. It starts with God. It starts in praying. It starts in acknowledging him and saying, Lord, I give you these children. I give you this business. I give you my health journey. It starts in getting your knees and saying, God, do it in me. Lord, I start with you. I don't know. I think I know if this is the right way, but what do you think about it? He want to be in a relationship where he can have an exchange, where he can say some things to you and you gonna follow. The same way you would want your husband or your wife to follow, he want to know that you'll follow. So if we would just ask God, but it's going to always require us to give something. So before I end, I just want to give you a practical example. Now, this is the extreme, but I want to just give you a practical example of what this looks like, because I haven't shared this yet. But as I said, whenever you follow Christ, he is always going to require you to do something. You're a participator. You can't follow him and keep your agenda, but you have to be willing to give up. And that most time is your will, your way, what you think is right. But he's always giving you more. And so y'all listen, short version, I've been on this following process for a long time. I've been following God. I've been listening to God, and he's been directing my life. That's what purposely living is all about. Walking this faith thing out, walking out, allowing the Bible not to be just something you read and memorize and quote, but how are you applying it to your life? And so I came to last year, y'all. I had a goal. My goal was in April of this year, to be able to leave my job and put in my resignation. But you know, following Jesus, it requires something. So what happened? Short version is, probably about around September, October, I started getting this nudge through several ways. God used people. Someone said some things to me. I, in prayer, went to praying, and God confirmed, it's time to go. Like, I want you to put your resignation in. You're going to go about, I'm going to show you how to, you're going to do your business. You're going to launch some things full time. Now, let me just say, that sounds great because I had a goal, right? But my goal was in April of this year. This, like, coming in October, November. So I'm like, Lord, I haven't saved yet this amount of money, and I haven't seen this amount of profit. And, you know, hold on, you know, because it's like, wait a minute, I got a plan. I'm tight. I'm structured. We don't just jump like this. But God said, you're going to follow me. And it got to be a point that things had been said and I had been praying, and y'all, it's like it got silent. Okay, because God, like, I ain't got nothing else to say. Just like with them disciples, he said, come and follow. He didn't give them no other instructions. And I said, oh my God, Lord. But it was, y'all, I've been following God long enough to know that when he speaks, I have to obey. I don't have to, but I choose to. And I said, if God is asking me to do this, and I will tell you right now, I will not lie, I was scared. I cried. I was fearful. I was like, Lord, you know, okay. And then look, let me tell you how the enemy worked. I just got a raise. Listen, I done got a raise at my job. So I'm doing good. I'm like, oh my God, like, you gonna tell me to leave my job right now? Like, if I get four more checks, you know, I'm calculating. But y'all, when I tell you, the Lord began to say some things to encourage me. And I said, you know what, God? I had to make up my mind to follow him. Even when I didn't understand, he didn't give me no great plan. He didn't say, quit your job because I'm about to level you up. You're going to make seven figures. You're going to have 10,000. He didn't say none of that. He just said, leave. That's all I got. I ain't getting no promises. But I know God well enough to know that in his word, he said his plans for me are never evil. They never to set me up for bad. They never, you know, they not coming to harm me, but they will teach you some things. They will strengthen you. They will take you somewhere. So I say that to say I took God on his word. Y'all, I can't even begin to tell you. So I put my notice in December. My last day was in January, right? I'm gonna just put it this way. The Lord is blowing my mind. He's blowing my mind at that quick, the things he's done. The things he's done in my team. The things he's done. I'm like, I can't even imagine working at the job at this point. But it was like, whereas I felt like God was taking, and I'm like, God, I don't see. But God requires us to follow us. And when he see that he has our obedience, he'll begin to open up doors. Y'all, he been open up doors. In like I ain't even missed the income like that. Because God has been faithful. Whereas I did one thing, he opened up another door. And so why am I saying that? I ain't telling you to leave your job. Because now, that was a plan. That was something I prayed about. I have worked a full-time job and worked my business, okay? So I understand what it's like to do too. That's something God has to tell you to do. Make sure you hear from the Lord. Don't tell us what Latrice said. Cut down. I ain't telling you to do that, okay? All right. But what I'm telling you is you have to take God at his word. Following him is so important. So why? As I get ready in this Fit Friday, it's a lifestyle, y'all. Why am I driving? Follow Jesus so you can get fit. Here's why. Ultimately, God wants to use you and me. But he cannot use us fully if we won't commit to following. That's the bottom line. You got to be willing to let him be your guide. He's our teacher. You can't teach the teacher. The teacher want to take you somewhere, but you can only go so far as you remain teachable. We are God's product. In case you, I don't know, maybe you think you your product. No, but we were created for his glory. We are at full usage when we are being led by him. His desire is that we would be demonstrators, that we would be representative and a witness for him. And so we have to follow him so we can be the right representation. We don't want to be fraudulently representing him. The Bible tells us that some of us, we gonna get up there and say, well, I sung in your name, I prophesied in your name, I preached in your name, oh, I did this in your name. And he gonna say, I never knew you. Y'all, do you know how real that is? I never knew you. Depart from me. So I'm telling you to get fit so that you can be the right representation wherever you are on your journey, parenting, marriage, homeschool, getting your health journey. It begins when we follow Christ, y'all. It begins when we acknowledge him in all that we do. And I even want you to look at this scripture, Proverbs 1:7. This is how I'm ending. In the Message version, it says, start with God. The first step in learning is bowing down to God. Y'all, I'm telling you, get fit. Y'all can, you know, be like, girl, she's so CD. Everything got to be Jesus. Everything got to be Jesus. It starts with him. Proverbs 1:7. Listen, I tell you, don't just listen to me. Go read it for yourself. The Message version, it says, start with God. The first step in learning is bowing down to God. So if you want to purposely live as a parent, if you want to purposely live as in your business, if you want to level up, if you want to have peace in your mind, if you want to know how in this pandemic to still keep your joy, how when you're trying to balance and find harmony through all these different avenues and things that are going on, it begins in getting fit. When you start on with God, when you give your goals to him, he will give you what you need. I'm so serious, y'all. There's been so many things since I've left my job that I just simply said, God, I don't know. I don't know which way to go. I think this is right, but what do you think? And y'all, I will tell him all the time, you have the people, place, and the plan. You are my source. And y'all, as quick as I can say it, God will dispatch the resource that I need. I'm telling you, it starts with God. And when you do that, welcome to the fit lifestyle. You'll be fit in your parenting. You're going to be fit in your body. You're going to be fit in your mind. Because guess what? It's a daily process. You don't go to the gym for a month, and because you went to the gym for a month, you fit for the year. I don't know what plan that is, but y'all sign me up. No, you don't do 30 days and then get 365 of a fit lifestyle. You got to keep doing it. It's in your continual going to the gym. You got to continue to keep those habits. And that's how you continue to get fit. You don't just get a lifetime of fitness. Every day you got to be willing to do something and give up 30 minutes of your time so that you can gain what? A fit lifestyle, so that you can gain some strength, so that you can have a healthy body. You have to be willing to get in the word and pray so that you can gain and have peace in your mind and in your body and in your soul. So y'all, it all begins with Christ. That's my Fit Friday. I pray you be encouraged. It's your girl, Latrice Bartley. Bye.